What's up everybody, Jonathan Gauthier here. Welcome to yet another video. In this video, I want to address the million dollar question, probably the question that I am most frequently asked. And this question is about the spin, is how to get your horse to spin on that inside pivot foot. And anyways, it's always been a question that I never really found a perfect answer to or a direct answer to, because it's such a broad subject. But anyways, here's my take on that. Hope you enjoy it. How do you get your horse to spin on his correct pivot foot? Okay, so we all know that the horse should be spinning on his inside pivot foot. The reason why we want that, and the reason why a horse would want to do that is because, just like when you're a lead departure, a lead change, or you're loping, whatever you're doing, if you're spinning to the left, you're in the horse's left diagonal. And the way the diagonal works is that energy coming from the outside hind pushing. So the outside hind push, it's the drive, okay? And it pushes out through the inside shoulder, and the extended range of motion of the inside leg is the exit, is the output of that diagonal. So a horse that can really travel perfectly in their diagonal is gonna be a horse that can, you know, that's gonna be straight, elevated, and that it's gonna feel good. It's a horse in a good position to do a lead change or to do anything. So the goal, and this is why that if you, if you want to know how to get your horses to spin on a correct pivot foot, I have a video on the platform that's called All You Need to Know About the Spin. And it's a multi-video series of all about the spin. So I encourage you to go watch that if you have not, because this will tell you all of the things that I think are very important in order to have a horse that spins in the best position possible. And in order for a horse to really pivot well on its inside pivot foot, he needs to be really pushing good with that outside hind and really reaching into that spin with that inside front. So this is why that my program, if you know my program, or if you are interested to know my program, subscribe to the Comfort Zone video training series, where in the foundation there's a lot of emphasis that go into the horse learning to follow his nose and lifting that inside shoulder so that I can control that inside step, really lifting and really stepping and reaching into that turn as much as I can. And so a good indicator, like I say often, that a horse is doing the right thing with its front is when I can really see that inside step really stick out from the shoulder when it's stepping. So it's not like a short step stuck under, it's really like a nice big step. So when I know that I can get my horse's inside step to really be a good lateral movement to the side that's gonna encourage a good crossover, this is step one. So if I can get that, usually I'm not going to worry about what the hind end is doing. I rarely worry about the hind end is doing. So it's not something that if I were you, I would consider a problem until you have a really final product, a broke horse that you spin ready for a good horsemanship class or good ranch riding class or cow horse or reining or whatever you do, whatever you're going to use that spin for. Then at that point, what you want is you want a horse that, let's say, is in a very good position when you're standing, and then when you open the door and you ask him to get into a turn, you want a horse that's gonna sit there, use that outside hind to push themselves into that turn and step inside very clean and cross over nicely and put all of their energy on their front legs and what the front legs are doing. And if the horse focuses on their front legs and really has a good mechanical movement that they understand and they do it balanced, usually the hind is going to do what it's supposed to do. So I don't think that it's going to be beneficial to anyone to really put too much attention on trying to get that inside hind leg to just really, you know, stick to the ground like a screw and the horse pivot around it, because there's going to be some time where a horse might need to adjust the balance and step on the outside and come back to the inside. So I would say focus on what the front legs are doing first. And again, if you do want to work on it, which I find it very interesting and it's a fun thing to work on, well then side passing into the turn is going to be one of the many exercises that are going to help fix that. Anything that you're going to do on the horse that's going to just increase that diagonal, make sure that you have that hind end really pushed very well and all that energy channeled through that inside, and that horse is forward, is straight, that's off your out leg, you know. So side passing into a turn and all of these good exercises are gonna be exercises that are gonna help you fix that. fix that or improve that. So, you know, but again, I think that don't consider this too much of a problem. And I believe that if you have a problem where the hind end of your horse is just moving around too much, or it's not stable, or it's not doing what it should, well, that's probably, again, just a byproduct of the front not doing what it should. So I wouldn't worry too much about the back end. Focus more on the shoulder and the front end, and then do some exercises around it that are going to help you put your horse in a good diagonal, in a perfect diagonal, in order to be able to do a spin. A good indicator that you have, you know, that your horse is spinning in a good diagonal, and that's often like one of the main problems main problem that I see is that people side passing their horses into the turn. Okay, so let's say the horse is side passing fairly well, and then they allow the horse into the turn. You don't want to be side passing and then trying to make the horse turn, because if the horse is side passing properly, what you want is you want the horse to go into that spin without changing its body position. Okay, so you want that side pass to say, okay, now I'm in my diagonal, my horse is side passing perfectly, so I open the inside leg and my horse goes from side pass to locking that hind end and into a cross. And you want your horse to be able to go from the side pass to the turn without any like shift in the rib cage, shift in the shoulder, any resistance, anything that's going to change from your side pass to your spin is your problem. This is what you want to work on. So if you can really get to where your horse side passes into that turn perfectly without losing forward motion, without resisting, without changing its body position, then you're one step closer to being able to lock in that outside, that inside hind into that spin, and you know that you have your horse in the best position possible. Then you can work on being able to maintain that diagonal through the turn, but I encourage you to just focus on getting into it right and finishing it right, and eventually this will connect together, and then the horse will be able to stay in that good diagonal throughout the entire time. So again, I encourage you to go and watch the videos about the spins. There will be more coming, but every horse is different, and so yes, you know, there are some things that you can do to encourage the horse to pivot on its inside leg, but every horse is different, every program is different, and there's going to be many different reasons why they don't do it. So there's not one good answer to that, I believe. So this is my two cents on that. This is something I've been wanting to address that way. So I hope this helps you. I hope this answers your question. Now, very interesting day today for me. I'm going to be headed over to Dallas. They have moved the WISA trade show from Denver to Dallas. This is the trade show where all the retailers are going to be going to pick up their the stuff that they will carry in their tack shop from the manufacturers. And as you well know, I work closely with the manufacturers of my family's bit and spur collection. And so I'm gonna go over there and discuss that a little bit and look at the new products. So I'm gonna try and catch videos of that and update you on all that in the next video. Until then, if you haven't yet subscribed to this channel, please do so, as it helps me grow and reach more people. And to be honest, the way that it's kind of kicking into gear right now and picking up some steam, I'm watching my analytics. I'm a little bit addicted to watching my analytics on YouTube, continue to increase. So this is super motivating and exciting. But it seems like whatever kicks this YouTube into gear are people subscribing, people liking your video, commenting on your video. So if you have a minute and you appreciated this video, then I would appreciate you doing that. Until then, I'll see you in the next video. Take care.